days are drowning in darkness. My dreams are shattered away. My days are drowning in darkness. My dreams are shattered away. Never feel I'm all alone. Someone lend your arms to save me. My days are drowning in darkness. My dreams are shattered away. My success is my handwriting. My success is my handwriting. My success is my handwriting. My success is my handwriting.
Veda Handwriting Lab aims at providing a foolproof, time-tested, and result-oriented approach towards training. Both the teachers and students develop a unique style of handwriting. It is rather a program aimed at restructuring and transforming the handwriting practice of the whole school system.
Hi, greetings from Veda Handwriting Lab. My name is Reason Gopinath. I am the founder for CEIR, Center for Education Initiative and Research, and the director for Veda Handwriting Lab. You remember, our teachers used to say, you write more, that can improve your handwriting. You know, writing more will not improve your handwriting. Writing correctly will improve your handwriting. You know what happened when you write more? You repeat the same mistake again and again, and those mistakes become part of your writing. So at Handwriting Lab, we say, don't write more, write correctly. Today we will see how to write correctly. I mean, we will have some unlearning today and we relearn something new. Because in Handwriting Lab, we always say there is nothing called good or bad handwriting. There is only trained or untrained handwriting. Before getting into the movement skill, Let me show you a small video of the writing preparation.
The first and foremost thing is our sitting posture. How to sit for a writing? Both legs should be parallel on the ground. When you put both the legs parallel on the ground, naturally we sit straight. Suppose if you cross your legs, you see there'll be small bending comes. Whenever the writing comes, we should naturally come to the sitting posture. I'll repeat, both legs should be parallel on the ground. Naturally we sit straight. The second thing which affects the writing is the distance between table and chair. And the simplest thing is, if you can comfortably place both the elbows on the table, that is the proper distance between table and chair. The third thing which affects our writing is the angle of the book or position of the book. Actually, the position of the book should be 45 degree in angle. So, if a right-hander, keep your book straight, here the 90 degree comes. If the right hander, the right corner of the book should go up, precisely 40-45 degree. Suppose if I am a left hander, the left corner, the 90 degree comes here, the left corner of the book should go up. I am a right hander, I am keeping my book straight, here the 90 degree comes, so I am keeping the right corner of my book upward. So it will be precisely 40-45 degree, and one hand should be on top of the book. Why one hand on top of the book? Normally if you observe, the book or paper will be in the same place. We always go with the book. The moment you change your sitting posture, it affects your writing. So why one hand should be on top of the book? When you write, when you come down, the book should go up. We should never go with the book. I repeat, one hand should be on top of the book. When we write, when we come down, the book should go up. We should not go with the book.
If you correct this writing preparation, the sitting posture, angle of the book, distance between table and chair, you know, the book moving upward, naturally some improvement will happen.
Let's understand that handwriting is both a science and an art. It is the neuroimpulses that make the hand to write. There's also development of writing readiness and the attainment of eye-hand coordination, along with the development of dexterity and fine motor skill development, which make it easy for someone to write.
So now you understand, it's not handwriting, it is mind which makes the hand to write. I tell you a simple example. Have you noticed, when you ask some children to write D, they write B? Are we teaching them wrongly? Then why they are writing wrongly? Because if you show D and B to the mirror, D looks B, B looks D. When you teach this mirror image letters to a child, some children will pick the image of D and register in their mind as B. When you ask them to write D, the image registered is B, they write B. It is a mind and hand coordination. Now let me explain you the day-to-day issues of handwriting.
A single pattern of writing for teachers will sort out many handwriting issues. For an example, in a day of 8 periods, 8 teachers are writing on the board in 8 different styles. The child psychologists say the child imitate the teachers. Out of this 8 different handwriting exposed to a child on a daily basis, which one the child should imitate? Which makes them more confused?
As teachers, we are very concerned about our students' handwriting. For that, we either give a copywriting book or a 4-line book. And this process starts from lower KG, sometimes it goes up to 8th standard. Meaning, on an average, the child is writing this copywriting book for nearly 8 to 10 years. Are you happy after 10 years of their handwriting? Why you are not happy? You know, 8 years the child is writing this copywriting book and you are making them to write also. But then why there is no improvement in their handwriting? The answer is very, very simple. Because this 8-10 years, we are giving them a copywriting book. Copywriting is not handwriting. For an example, you look at the child's copywriting book and the same child's English notebook, you will find two different handwriting. Yes or no? Meaning, in copywriting book, the child get a model. He copy, he imitate and write on the book. But in English notebook, there is nothing to copy and write. Meaning, this 8-10 years, we are not actually giving handwriting practice, we are giving copywriting practice. Copywriting is not handwriting. Handwriting is brain writing or mind writing. Handwriting is a 100% scientific activity. It's not the handwriting. Hand is made to write by the mind or brain. This is a neuro impulses created by one's brain give instruction to the hand. Hand simply execute that job. It's not that handwriting. Hand is made to write by the brain. So, handwriting is a 100% scientific activity. Do you think copywriting is scientific? It is 100% unscientific activity. Now you understood why you are not happy after 8 years or 10 years of their copywriting practice? Copywriting is not handwriting. You ask any child, they can write alphabets. Everybody knows how to write alphabets. But why they are not writing properly? Meaning, handwriting is nothing but a movement skill. What these children are missing today, they miss this art of movement, this skill of movements. Let me explain this movement skills in a better way. Please take a sheet of paper and pen. Just make some strokes from bottom to up, like this. Now, you start with a small tick up, tick up. Now tell me which is easy to move, with tick or without tick? With tick. Now, as I told you, handwriting is nothing but a movement skill. If you start with a small tick up, it is easy for you to move. Now, let us have a small experiment. Let us understand more about this movement skill. You take a sheet of paper and write a word good in small letters. G-O-O-D in small letters. This is a very magical word. Please write good 3 times in small letters. Now, let us understand this handwriting patterns. There are only 2 patterns. Either it should be in print or it should be in cursive. The basic difference is that in print style, you should lift your hand in each letter. In cursive, you should only lift your hand till you complete the word. You know why this is called print?
Handwriting is actually the kinesthetic experience. You will notice that when you write in cursive, the letters are all connected and it uses less fine motor skills. When you write in manuscript, you will notice that you have to keep picking up your pencil and replacing it to form each letter. Now, young students are fine motor skill challenged, so when we ask them to begin with manuscript, we actually are asking them to do the thing that is more difficult. This is because cursive was designed for the human hand, whereas manuscript was designed for the printing press.
Print need more fine motor coordination. As I said, there are only 2 patterns. 99% of the students mix this 2 handwriting. It is neither print nor cursive. Now, we should always advise our children, never mix 2 different handwriting. Why? Because first of all, there is nothing called mixed handwriting. Then why a child is writing in mixed handwriting? The answer is very simple. The child who can join 2 letters doesn't know how to join another 2 letters. So it is not an ability. It is an inability. Now, you underline the first G, second G and third G of your handwriting. Just compare the first G and second G. Is your first G and second G look same? Or your second G and third G look same? There will be slight difference. Am I right? But you only wrote it. Why it is changing all the time? Because the word good, all the letters are moving in anti-clockwise. When you write any letter or any word, it moves in anti-clockwise, you lose the grip. For an example, in a paragraph, if there are 10 G's, 10 G's looks different. It affects your neatness. So, in handwriting lab methodology, we say either the letter should start with a small tick up or a tick down. Our methodology is very simple. Anybody can learn it. Tick up, tick down. Meaning, L should go with a tick up and N should come with a tick down. It is easy for to join and easy for us to move. Because I told you, handwriting is nothing but a movement skill. Now, you just make a circle on the air in clockwise. 2-3 times. Now do it in anti-clockwise. Which is easy to move, clockwise or anti-clockwise? Naturally, it is clockwise. The word good, all four letters are moving in anti-clockwise. Please take your pen. We will write the word good. You make a small tick up and a curve. A tick up and a slanting curve. Is it look like a slanting grandfather's tick? Now, this is the first frame. From this tick up and a curve, I come down to the bottom, I create a letter C. That is the first letter, basic letter. And make a small tick up and a curve, that's a frame. Come down to the bottom, create a letter C. I can also make a C like this, but my next C will be like this. My third C will be like this, because it is moving in anti-clockwise. When I write in anti-clockwise, I lose my shape. So that I will put a frame first, like a photo frame, and write the letter within the frame. So that whenever I write my C, I'll make the same shape. Now what I'll do, from this slanting grandfather's stick, I come down to the bottom, I'll just touch the neck, I'll make it descender, I'll create a letter G. I make a slanting grandfather stick, I create a letter C, I'll just touch the knee, I'll come down and make a small bond, I'll create the letter G. Please write a G like this. Now, make another slanting grandfather stick, the curve is very important. Come down to the bottom, create a letter C, touch the knees, make an upward knot, you create the letter O. Please write one more O. Make it take up. Slanting grandfather's take. Come down to the bottom. Create a letter C. Touch the knee. Make an upward note. You create a letter O. Now the last letter D. Make it take up. Slanting grandfather's take. Come down to the bottom. Create a letter C. Now touch the neck, make an ascender and a tail, you create a letter T. Please write this word good and please write only one time. Because as we know, writing more will not improve our handwriting, writing correctly will improve our handwriting. Now, let me ask you a small question. Do you agree that handwriting is an art? No doubt, it is 100% an art. Yes or no? If handwriting is an art, why are we writing then? You understood the point here? We always say handwriting is a science and we make the child to write copywriting books. And we say handwriting is an art and we make the child to write. If handwriting is an art, we should never write. We should only draw. Ravi Verma, write a picture or draw a picture? Let us have a small experiment here. I'll teach you one technique which we call air tick. Just raise your hand like this and make a circle, big circle Which part of your hand is moving? Your shoulder. In this technique, only your shoulder should move. And you should fix your eyes on tip of your index finger. Your index finger. Now, what will I do? I will draw this word good on there. Like this. I'll just show you first. I'm raising my hand like this. I look at the tip of my index finger. I'll make a small tick up and a curve. Could you see the curve? A small tick up and a curve. A slanting grandfather's tick. I come down to the bottom and I'll make another curve. Could you see this letter C? I'll repeat. I'll make a tick up and a curve. I'll come down to the bottom. I'll create a C. Now, what will I do? I'll make a small tick up, slanting grandfather's tick, the curve. And I'll come down to the bottom. I'll touch the neck. I'll create a letter G. Then, I'll make a tick up. I'll make another slanting grandfather's tick. C, I'll create a letter O. Another take up, slanting grandfather's tick. The curve is very important. Come down to the bottom, C, touch the neck, another O. Last, take up, slanting grandfather's tick. C, touching the neck, now an ascender and a tail. I'll create a letter D. So, please come for this position. Only your shoulder should move and you should look at the tip of your index finger. Shall we start together? Take up, slanting grandfather's tick. The curve is very important. C and a G. I'll create another slanting curve, grandfather's tick. I'll create a letter C. I'll touch the neck, O. I'll make another slanting grandfather's tick, C. Another O. Tick up, slanting grandfather's tick, C, ascender, I'll create a letter D. When you write on the air, you are putting no pressure. When you move your shoulder, your brain cells will easily capture that pressure. And that no pressure is the pressure you should give to the pen. Meaning, when you write, you should give this aortic pressure, meaning no pressure. Now, I will write this in cursive. Just observe me. I'm going to write this word good in cursive. How? I'll raise my hand. I'm ready to do my air take. I'll start my take up, slanting curve. C, G without lifting my hand. Another curve. C, O, another curve. C, O without lifting another curve. C and a D. I'll repeat once again. Just observe me first. Take up, slanting. Could you see the curve? Take up, slanting grandfather's tick. C, G without lifting. Another curve. C, O, another curve. C, O, another curve. C, D. Please do it with me. Raise your hand like this. Look at the tip of your index finger. Don't look anywhere. Look at the tip of your... Because you should see the letters. Take up, slanting grandfather's tick. C, G without lifting, another curve, C, O, C, O, C, and D. So you should draw this. Now take the pen, write on your paper this word good in cursive without putting any pressure. You should put no pressure, zero pressure while you write. You can make mistake, no problem. Take a sheet of paper. Write this word good without putting any pressure in cursive. Take up, slanting grandfather's tick, C, G, without lifting, another curve, C, O, C, O, and C, D. Please write good only one time. Could you feel a kind of a flow now? If you put pressure, nothing will happen. Drop your pen. The last time we will do, this time we will do 100%. Raise your hand like this, along with me. Look at the tip of your index finger. Make a small take up and a curve. C, G without lifting, another curve. C, O without lifting, another curve. C, O without lifting another curve. C and D. Once again, last time. Take up slanting grandfather's cheek. Please do it along with me. Take up slanting grandfather's cheek. The curve is very important. C, G without lifting another curve. C, O, another curve. C, O, another curve. C, D. Now you take the pen. Now 100% without putting any pressure, you please write good. Take up standing grandfather's cheek. C, G without lifting another curve. C, O, another curve. C, O, another curve. C, D. Now are you writing or drawing now? If you put no pressure, you will feel like drawing. Because handwriting is an art. You should never write it. Now you know, in handwriting, legibility, neatness and speed is very important. Now you compare the first good and last good. Which good is more legible? Which is more neat? Which good you wrote fast? So you must have found some improvement between the first and last good. Yes? Now you know what real change happened here? By using this one technique, you must have seen some improvement in your handwriting. Am I right? Meaning, the first good is untrained and the last good is little bit trained. Meaning, there can't be good or bad handwriting. That's the reason at the handwriting lab, we always say there is nothing called good or bad handwriting. There is only trained or untrained handwriting. See, improving your handwriting is not a big deal. You have to learn only these movement skills. If you learn these 5 basic techniques, 5 basic letters and 5 basic frames, you can improve your handwriting 100%. Only 2-3 hours you have to spend to learn this movement skill. Once you learn this movement skill, you can improve your handwriting and you can improve others' handwriting also. So our system is a step-by-step system. We first repair your letters. Then we combine the letters, we create the word, then to sentence, then to paragraphs. For example, the first frame slanting grandfather's cheek becomes the C. The same C becomes an A. The same become a D. Same become a G. Same become a Q. Same become an O. Same become an X. Same become an E. Similar way, if you correct one frame, we call tick up, down, you create a letter I. The same I become a J. The same I become a T. Same become a P. Same movement you can become a K, L, H and F. So, dear teachers, please understand writing more will not improve our handwriting. Writing correctly will improve our handwriting. There is nothing called good or bad handwriting. There is only trained or untrained handwriting. And we should slowly move from 4-line to 2-line to single line. The real practice has to be given in single line, not in 4-line.
The handwriting lab comes with a complete package. We provide a handwriting kit which contains the manicule memory board, training manual, daily practice worksheet and a practice manual. A one-day training program for all the teachers and a training DVD along with a trainer's manual to help the teachers train the students are part of the package.
To teach these movement skills, we have actually developed something called a manicule memory board. This is the crux of this program. If the child uses this manicule memory board and learn this movement skills, he or she can retain this handwriting forever. See, manicule memory board is a revolutionary device.
The most influenced part of Veda handwriting is that it's highly scientific.
Copywriting is actually a repeated errors. Again and again, writing the same mistakes. But this is a very good handwriting program. It gives a perfect solution to all issues.
And first of all, I would like to thank Mr. Srisen Popinath and Veda Handwriting Lab. See, this was my first handwriting. And after this lab, my handwriting improved such a lot. You can see this.
Will affect our board examinations and our future also very drastically. Most of us have improved our handwriting in a big time.
I really didn't expect that our handwriting will be changed so nicely in such a short period of time.
Our children have made a drastic change in their handwriting and they are quite happy about this.
Change in the handwriting for the first page and second page.
This is first one, huh?
Yes.
Oh my god.
I show my handwriting before I could be trained and after the training, and you can see what is the improvement.
This concept was first visualized as a pilot project in our school. I am also happy to say that it was one of the biggest achievements, success stories of this institution.
When I saw this, even I shocked. There is a fantastic changes, a tremendous changes in the handwriting.
While starting this program, I was also doubting how it affect the handwriting of the children. But the change is marvelous.
I can see a damn improvement in the handwriting of almost all the students and even my teachers too.
We tried in many ways, but we were not succeeded. At last, fortunately, school got Mr. Srisen Gopinath.
By this time, 4 months training is over. It has made a lot of changes in students' handwriting.
So they gave a special training for my teachers, and within months, I could find the difference.
Teachers got a training program here, but their improvement is marvelous because they have improved a lot.
And the character of these teachers and students have improved a lot because of the disciplined handwriting of the students as well as teachers.
And teachers, they are enjoying it actually.
After we got implemented with the handwriting lab, I could see even my teachers writing like students very legibly without committing a single mistake. They're very confident.
It made a lot of changes in the handwriting of teachers.
After undergoing the training from Veda Handwriting Lab, they find it, taking it as a game actually.
Within 3 months, a fantastic changes took place in the handwriting.
Earlier, I have attended the training of handwriting from other resources, persons. But it was just practicing. Do this way, write this way, practice this way. But Veda handwriting is entirely different approach.
And the parents also gave a very good feedback about the handwriting and the attitude towards writing also.
Within 3 months, parents are happy with the words handwriting, and even teachers are happy with the handwriting of the students. And we are getting good results because of handwriting.
When I conducted the exam for our students, suddenly within 50 minutes I told them, I took one printout and gave to all the students. So within 10 minutes they finished, and even the paper is with me. So I was seeing that, and it is very good.
Thank you so much, and we will continue this program for the coming couple of years.
I am a principal of an international school, and this is the true story of my school. We had great faculty, enthusiastic students, world-class infrastructure, and above all, very supportive management. Our students were trained in many extracurricular activities, and the school was aiming at the holistic development of the children. But whenever we got the result sheets of the students, I was very anxious. Even though our students were well prepared, they could not score well in the examinations, and had a meeting with my teachers to resolve this handwriting issue. The problem was not in their answers, but in their presentation skills. and in the writing pattern. We could not find any effective solution even after considering many options. We were in trouble. I was really worried. Then I happened to watch a video sent by a friend about Veda handwriting. I called them immediately. Veda Handwriting Lab started their program by training our teachers. This was something very new to our teachers. They thoroughly enjoyed themselves undergoing the sessions. What an appropriate and scientific style of teaching. Teachers should acquire the skill before they imparting it to the students. After getting trained by Veda, our teachers began training the students. Our students really got fascinated by this unique, innovative method of teaching. I could see the tremendous improvement in handwriting by the teachers as well as students within a very short span of time. Both of them now follow a common pattern of beautiful handwriting. My major concern of handwriting was disappeared very soon. I am a happier person now. I wish my kids a happy writing.